Welcome back, Mark Dickinson with you. And here we go, this training today is about setting the table. Now, what I'm actually going to talk about, most people never see. So if you look in front of you, there's a table here. We just chose this table at random. And seriously, we just chose this table at random. There's no preparation done, it's just as it is. But I want to show you the difference between the way the table is right now and how we should set a table professionally for service. So here's the deal. If you look at the table, you'll see that this supla is not quite on the table. So when we train, we take to the airplane, put the supla exactly on the edge of the table. This is the first thing. So if you do that, it makes a massive difference to the perception. If you go to Asia, they have something called feng shui. And in feng shui, it's all about the spirit and the feeling of how things are. And it's not always what you see. So now we put the supla in the correct place. So if you see that, it's already a minor change. Now, what happens next is you have to have the cutlery and the plates in the right place as well. So what happens is, in your restaurant, there's always invisible guidelines. So on the supla, there's a pattern. So we can follow the pattern. So for example, the plate, there's a line here on the supla, we can put the plates exactly there. And then what we do is we decide to put the heel of the knife at a certain place on each supla. So since we have the Instagram logo for the restaurant here, we can put the heel of the knife right next to it. The second decision is whether to put the fork heel next to the knife heel or the fork tip next to the knife tip. So here on this table, what we had is a variety. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a decision that the heel of the fork should be on the line. So if we do that, then that takes just a few seconds to put each of those in the right place. And what you're going to see is, as I do this, so the table will look different. Now, perhaps you're thinking, well, what about if we're busy? Well, the difference is that if you train your employees to do this right, they'll do it naturally, they'll do it instantly. And now look at my table. Now, there's still a couple of things which need fixing. One, here we have this promo card. Now, I want to bring this promo card close in and show you that on this promo card, it's dirty. This is not acceptable. But you see, what happens is, because we're busy, employees don't take the time to see these things. What we need to do with something like this is, either we can clean it or we throw it away. So I have a clean one right here, and we set that on the table. Now, the other thing that I want to share with you is the napkins. If you look at the napkins, they have a logo, but on the other side, there is no logo. So what we ask the employees to do is, quite simply, take the napkins, divide them in half, flip them round, and put them in the napkin stand. So if you would be sitting on this side or this side, the logo would be facing you. So you could do that, have it this way. The next is that the top of the salt pot is not clean. So the salt pot should be clean, and check it, make sure that it has inside it what it should. And there's my phone ringing, excuse me for that. Okay, and the pepper pot, just turn it quarter of a turn in your hand and put it back on the table. So there is a short guide to the most important points about setting up your table perfectly. Make sure, again, I'll go through the points, use the supla absolutely perfectly placed. Then on the supla, place the cutlery in exactly the same place. Put the plate in exactly the same place. Make sure the table is clean. Make sure that your promotion material is clean. Napkins, logos are facing out. Salt and pepper are powerful and that your floral arrangement is in good condition. And this, my friends, is how to set the table. You go away from that, the next part is to check the sofa and to check the chairs. So this table, the chairs are slightly mixed up. So we want the chair to be perfectly positioned in front of the customers. See? And when you're done, the chairs should form a perfect line, and that perfect line should go right down the restaurant. As soon as you do this, your restaurant has a totally different feel. You walk into the restaurant and you feel this is a nice place.